Hello guys and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we are going to learn about palindrome numbers and how to check whether a number is a palindrome number or not in Java. So let's get started. So what is a palindrome number? A palindrome number is a number that is same after reversing, that is, a number which reversed gives the same number. For example, 404. If you reverse 404, you will get 404, which is equal to the original number. Hence, it is a palindrome number. 131. If you reverse 131, you will get 131, which is equal to the original number. Hence, it is a palindrome number. 125. If you reverse 125, you will get 521, which is not equal to the original number. Hence, it is not a palindrome number. Now, let's see how to check whether a number is a palindrome number or not in Java. So, I've created a class palindrome number. In the class, I have created a function named main. So, let's take a number. Then, let's take 131. Because it is a palindrome number and it was given in the examples as well. Now we will be obtaining a reverse number. So let's put that reverse number in a variable named reverse equals 0. Now we have to split the number, that is why we will use a while loop. While number is greater than 0 means this while loop will run until the value of number is greater than 0. Once it will be equal to 0 or it will be less than 0, this while loop will not be executed. Print remainder will be equal to number mod 10. So this will give you the last digit of the number. Then this is the most important statement of this program. Plus remainder. So this statement will arrange the digits which you obtain in the manner which we want. Means it will reverse the digits. Then number equals number divided by 10. So after coming out of this while loop, we have to check whether this reverse number is equal to the original number. But then now we are putting a condition that while number is greater than 0, means after coming out of this while loop, the value of number will either be equal to 0 or it will be less than 0. That is, the value of number will be altered. That is why we have to take a copy of this number. Let's take the number of the variable as int copy number. Copy number will be equal to number. Now after coming out of this while loop, we have to check if copy number equals reverse, means it is a palindrome number. Wait, make sure this will be copy number is a palindrome number, and if it's not equal to the reverse number, then means it's not a palindrome number. Is not a palindrome number. So now I will just do a dry running of this program. First, the value of number is 131. So while 131 is greater than 0, means now the value means now 131 is greater than 0, that is why it will be true, means it will run. So in remainder will be number mod 10. So remainder will be 131 mod 10, which will give 1 because it gives the last digit. In remainder will be equal to number mod 10, which will be equal to 1. Then reverse will be equal to reverse into 10 plus remainder. So the value of reverse is 0 here. So then 0 into 10 will be 0 plus remainder, which is 1, so it will be 1. So value will be 1. And then here number equals number divided by 10, means 131 divided by 10 will give you 13. 13. So that means then the value of number is now 13. So is 13 greater than 0? Yes, it is greater than 0. That means why it will be again true. Now since it is true, the while loop will be executed and in remainder equals number mod 10. Now the value of number is 13. So 13 mod 10 will give you 3. So now remainder value of remainder will be equal to 3. Now reverse equals reverse into 10 plus remainder. We got the value of reverse as 1. So 1 into 10 plus remainder, which is 3, will give 13, because 10 plus 3 is 13. Then now the value stored in reverse will be 13. And number equals number divided by 10. So 13 divided by 10 will give you 1. So is 1 greater than 0? Yes, it is greater than 0. Which means it should run. So remainder will be equal to number mod 10. So 1 mod 10 will give you 1. So now the value stored in remainder will be equal to 1. So now reverse equals reverse into 10 plus remainder. The value stored in reverse is 13. So 13 into 10, which will be equal to 130 plus 1, which will be 131. 131. Now number equals number divided by 10. So 1 divided by 10, it will give you 0.1. Now since it is an integer data type, it will round off the 0.1 to 0. So is 0 greater than 0? No, it's not. That is why now it will be equal to false and it will not run. Means now we will come out of this while loop. Now what is in a reverse? The latest value in reverse is 131, and copy number equals number, which is equal to 131. So means 131 equals 131. Hence it is a palindrome number, else it is not a palindrome number. Now let's run the program to check. So here you can see 131 is a palindrome number. Now let's change the value of this. Let's write it as 152. Now 152 is not a palindrome number. So let's check what will be the output. So here you can see 152 is not a palindrome number. So we have got a desired output. So hope you all have understood this video. And that's all for today, guys.